The State Emergency Service, in light of the Weather Bureau's briefing, has elevated its preparedness level and is making sure that we've got crews on standby. And we're trying to make the community as well aware as we can of the risk for flooding and also for some more trees coming down over the upcoming days. We look at this protracted event from Saturday through to Tuesday being consistent with a lot of trees coming down, some minor flooding, and we ask the community to be very vigilant with where they're camping as the school holidays start, to stay away from fast flowing creeks, and as waters rise, to make sure nobody goes anywhere near the water and certainly don't drive through the water.
Where are you looking? Where do you expect to have the most jobs or to be focusing your efforts this weekend?
Certainly, based on the rainfall indications, we have got to focus up through the mid-north, but also through the Mount Lofty ranges, as well as the Adelaide metropolitan area, where we know that with already saturated ground, the root balls of the trees are going to be quite loose, and there is a propensity for more trees to come over with the higher winds that may be anticipated.
Yeah, how much of an effect does it have that we have already had quite a few weather events this winter?
Has its positives and its negatives. There's already been a lot of trees that have come down, but with the extra rain, there is that possibility that with wind coming through, the more trees may cause are caused to fall, and we ask people to stay away from areas where trees are coming down, and or that may come down, and not to park under trees, and to be very very diligent about keeping an eye on their trees through their yards and through their properties.
Have you? Sorry, we saw a couple of people rescued from floodwaters earlier this week. How frustrating is that for the SES that it keeps happening, that you keep seeing these people cross its waters?
Indeed, we've been involved in a couple of swift water rescue this week, and for individuals to enter floodwaters through areas and through creeks that are obviously swollen and are quite dangerous is very frustrating, and it's unsafe. It's unsafe for them. We don't want our rescuers needing to go into floodwaters unless absolutely necessary. So it's putting our people at risk. It's putting their own lives at risk. It's putting other members of the community at risk. If it's flooded, forget it. Don't make a silly decision to go into water. Once you go into that water, you lose control, and anything could happen from there. Please stay safe.
And the SES is making sandbags available in some areas.
Indeed, we've designated five different locations across the metropolitan area generally, and those locations are going to be published out shortly. And we ask people specifically on Saturday between 10 o'clock and 1 o'clock to go to those designated locations to pick up sandbags for a bit of self-preparedness. After those times, we're anticipating our crews will be busy, and we ask people to go there specifically between those times that we've put out on the media release.